In this class, we'll discuss about reflection of plane wave at normal incidence. Let's try to understand this by a diagram. Let's assume this is region 1. Let's take this is region 2 of different permeability and permittivity. Let's say that there is a plane wave incident at a normal, right? So let me say that it will have EI, HI. It is nothing but the incident electric field and the incident magnetic field, right? Let's try to write the expression of EI and HI. So my EI would be nothing but EIO e to the power minus j k 1 z. EIO is nothing but the initial amplitude, right, or nothing but the magnitude. It is propagating in plus z direction, right? So let me say that it is z direction, this is x direction, right? So the wave is propagating towards the plus z direction. So that's why it is minus z, right? If you remember, if you compare with the basic equation, which is cos omega t minus beta z, if it is minus beta z, it is propagating in plus z direction, right? Now it is minus j. K1 is nothing but the phase constant of the medium 1. It is the same as beta. So for the medium 2, we'll use at K2, right? So let's write the HI. So the HI would be nothing but HIO, the initial amplitude, e to the power minus j k 1 z, right? Now if I want to write the HI in terms of EI, how can I do that? We know that eta is nothing but E by H, right? So what would be H? H would be nothing but E by eta, right? Now this is one medium, this is another medium. Can I say that for this medium, I'll call it as intrinsic impedance as eta 1. For this medium, the intrinsic impedance as eta 2, right? So in this case, HI would be nothing but EIO by eta 1, right? E to the power minus j k 1 z. This will be my HI. Now when the wave is incident a norm, or I can say that a wave is at a normal incidence to a plane, there will be some part of the wave which will get transmitted, right? So we're gonna call that a transmitted wave, or which will have a both the components ET and HT, or nothing but the transmitted electric field and the transmitted magnetic field. Let's try to write that expression. So ET would be nothing but ETO e to the power minus j k 2 z, right? Because again the transmitted wave is also propagating along the plus z direction, so it is minus j k 2 z. Because this is medium 2, so we'll have different phase constant, so that is k 2. So what will be ht? Ht will be nothing but hto e to the power minus j k 2 z, right? So we have find ht. Now just write ht in terms of et. So ht would be nothing but eto by eta 2. Now we are talking about region 2, so it would be eta 2 e to the power minus j k 2 z. So we have written the wave equation, or nothing but ht and et. Now if I apply the, if I look, this wave is incident like this to this plane, right? Now if you observe, this is a normal incidence. So the normal incidence is across the z axis, right? If the normal is along the z axis, whatever component it has across the x and y will be the tangential component. We have already tried to understand this, right? If the normal is along the z, whatever is left is nothing but the tangential component, right? So we'll have a tangential component across x and across y. And as per the boundary condition, so I can say that from boundary condition, we know that h tan 1 will be equal to h tan 2, right? Provided there is no surface current. In this case, there is no surface current, right? H tan 1 will be equal to h tan 2. So let's see that what is h tan 1. So h tan 1 is nothing but, let's say that hi will be equal to ht, right? If I rewrite that equation, it would be nothing but eio by eta 1 e to the power minus j k1z is equal to eto eta 2 e to the power minus j k2z, right? Now if I make eta 1 is equal to eta 2, or if both are same medium, then it should be equal, right? But it is not possible, as we are talking about two different regions. Two different regions will have different permeability and permittivity, right? So eta 1 is equal to eta 2 will not make any sense, right? So what we are going to say is, let's say that if a wave is incident at a normal, which is nothing but if the wave is incident like this, some part of the wave is getting transmitted, right? But there will be some portion of the wave which will get reflected back, right? So we'll have one more component called as reflection coefficient. Let's see that. So it would be nothing but, let me call as, so there will be another wave which will be reflected. So let me call as ER and HR, right? So it will be nothing but the reflected electric and magnetic field. So ER will be given by ERO e to the power JKZ, it would be K1. Remember, I am writing plus KZ because the reflected wave is traveling across the minus Z direction. It is not along the plus Z direction, right? So I have to write, remember? In that case, it was traveling towards the plus z axis, so I have written minus k2z. So if it is traveling along the minus z, then it should be plus, right? So what will be hr? Hr will be nothing but hro e to the power j k1z, right? Now what will be the relation between these two? Now if I write the relation, now we are missing one more component here. Though we have taken this, let's try to understand this. Now what we mean by that is, let's say that this is the direction of propagation. This is an electric field. This is a magnetic field. Now this wave is incident. This wave is incident like this to the plane, right? When it gets reflected back, you can see that the direction of propagation gets changed. The magnetic field is again, sorry, the electric field is again pointing in the same direction, but the direction of magnetic field has been changed, right? So previously, if it was along, let's say that, assume that it is along y, it will become minus y, right? So we have to take care of that. So it will be minus, right? So hr will be nothing but minus ero, right, by eta 1 e to the power j k 1 z, right? So the minus sign because the direction of magnetic field will get changed, right? So that's a minus sign. Now at the boundary condition, we know that the at z is equal to 0, again at z is equal to 0, nothing but the boundary, all the tangential component would be equal, right? So I'll say that ei plus er will be equal to et, right? For the magnetic field, it will be hi plus hr, hi plus hr will be equal to ht, right? Let's take this equation and try to derive it. So if I take this equation, hi, I can write it as, hi can be written as, hi will be written as eio by eta 1, right? Hi is EIO by eta 1, right? Plus, what is HR? HR is nothing but minus ERO by eta 1. So, this is minus. So, this is minus ERO by eta 1. What is HT? HT is nothing but ETO by eta 2. So, it is nothing but ETO by eta 2, right? Now, we have to find actually the relation of ERO by EIO. We have to find the relation of ERO by EIO. So, it means I have to get rid of ETO, right? How can I get rid of ETO? The transmitted is nothing but the incident plus the reflected, right? So, I am going to call this rather than EIO, I am going to call as EI, right? So, I am going to rewrite this equation. It would be nothing but EI by eta 1 minus ER. It's nothing but, though we are considering about the reflected and incident, by eta 1 is equal to ET by eta 2. I'm going to replace ET with this equation. So, it would be EI by eta 1 minus ER by eta 1 equal to, what is ET? ET is nothing but EI plus ER by eta 1, right? Sorry, it would be eta 2, right? Let's simplify this equation. So, we have this equation which is EI by eta 1 minus ER by eta 1 is equal to EI by eta 2 plus ER by eta 2, right? Let's rearrange this equation. So, rearranging this equation, EI by eta 1 minus EI by eta 2 would be nothing but ER by eta 2 plus ER by eta 1. So, this would be nothing but taking EI common, eta 2 minus eta 1 divided by eta 1 eta 2. This would be nothing but ER common eta 1 eta 2, right? This would be nothing but eta 1 plus eta 2. Eta 1, eta 2 will get cancelled, right? So, this will be nothing but ER by EI would be nothing but, ER by EI would be nothing but eta 2 minus eta 1 by eta 2 plus eta 1. Remember, this is the ratio of reflected electric field to that of incident electric field, right? And this is given by a constant called as tau, which is called as reflection coefficient. This will be given by expression called as reflection coefficient. Now, if I have to find ET by EI again, right, it means a transmitted to that of incident. If I have to find transmitted by incident, again we are going to use the same equation, we are going to use the same expression. Let us see that. I am going to rub this. I am going to use the same equation, which is, or sorry, that's this equation, EI by eta 1 minus ER by eta 1. So, we are going to use this equation, EI by eta 1 minus ER by eta 1 is equal to ET by eta 2, right? So, what? We do not need the reflection part, right? We do not need the reflection. So, what we know that? We already know this, EI plus ER is equal to ET, right? We have written the equation somewhere, right? So, ER would be nothing but ET minus EI, right? Let us substitute that. So, ER would be nothing but ET minus EI by eta 1 is equal to ET by
eta 2.
Rearranging the equation, ei by eta 1 plus ei by eta 1, that will go this side, et by eta 2, right. So, this will go that side and will become plus et by eta 1, right. So, let us rearrange this. So, this will become 2 ei by eta 1 and this will become 1 plus eta 2, right. But I need an relation, I need a ratio of et by ei, right. Now, eta 1 will get cancelled. So, what we are left is, nothing but et by ei, which would be nothing but et by ei would be 2 eta 2 by eta 1 plus eta 2. And this quantity is given by another constant which is called as transmission constant, right. So, it is the ratio of the transmitted electric field to that of incident electric field. In this derivation, we have derived the relation of the reflected electric field to that of incident and the transmitted electric field to that of incident, right. So, we have find it out the reflection and transmission coefficient. We will see more on the coming videos.